Hi folks, I'm Samik and today we are at day 28 of 30-day series of SaaS Crash Course. On day 27, we talked about Google Search Console. Now today we are going to talk about Google OAuth screen and what exactly the permissions you required for that. So let's begin. So you have to go to console.cloud.google.com and you know what are the process of OAuth screen. So you can see for this project, I have proper OAuth configuration. Like this project is approved by Google to make Google sign-in easy with my users. So you can see what are like, actually like what are the things like in the green tick and these are allowed to me. And you can see what are the branding, like I'm using it for GrabLink. So app name, then support email, the logo, homepage, privacy policy, terms of service, authorized domain, and developer contact and things like that. And what type of audience I want, like in it is in production right now. So what exactly will it look for you if you are new to this? So let me go to the console and let me choose one project for you. So let's go for the MCP tutor. And again, I will make this live in few time, but right now it is in testing. So you can see if you go to OAuth screen, we will get all the details of what exactly do we need to fill. So let it load. So you can see, first of all, we have to give a brand name. So the app name should match with your, project name. So for example, if this MCP Twitter item is there, so here you must be using app name, right? So right now there is no app name. So let me go to the footer. So you can see right now it is just a GrabLink clone and that's why it is showing GrabLink. So whatever app name is there, like with spaces or without spaces, or with camel case item. So whatever name is there in the application, it should match with this particular app name. That is your first thing to do. Then support email will again be your support email. Then you have to upload logo, and the logo again should match with the logo. So you can see in GrabLink, I'm using this whole logo. So this whole logo should match with it. So the logo should be done. Now the homepage, again, right now it is universal, but when I will be deploying it, it will have its own particular domain that we can give here. And then the important parts come, that is privacy policy and terms of service. So this is your make or break for your project. So whether Google approves your project or not, so that particular depends on privacy policy and terms of service. So what exactly a privacy and term? So in the main application, the link of privacy policy and terms of service should be there. If it is not linked, if it is not shown in the main page, then Google will reject it. So it had happened to me. So these two items will be required. Now, once you have this, so what exactly to give in terms of service, what exactly to give in privacy policy? So again, it is for the grabling.xyz. So we have to change for MCP tutor. If we want to post, like upload for the OAuth verification, then we have to change everything. So you can see terms of acceptance, description of service. Again, it was like generated with the help of AI. I have not coded, like I've not written everything. So I have taken reference from already existing platforms like Postbridge and other platforms which are doing similar things. And I've taken reference to exactly what they are using, what terms of service, what privacy policy they are written. I've taken reference from them. Then I've modified according to my own words. Then I've asked AI to write it in professional and legal terms. So you can see it is completely according to my plan. And you can see what are the free plan, monthly plan, yearly plan, Google OAuth is there, Polaris, use plan, like whatever third party service integration is there, you have to mention that who is going to get that particular email that you have to mention. Rights, whether they want to delete item or not, whether you are GDPR compliant or not. So these are all the things which are required in terms of service and privacy policy, which you need to give. Otherwise, your app will be rejected for Google OAuth verification. And if Google OAuth verification is not there, then you cannot do Google sign up, right? So for that, you need Google OAuth verification. So again, IPR rights, limitation of liability. So you can just copy this format and you can copy paste it. There is no problem because this is the another format which is like approved, like GrabLink is approved. And then again, map your ideas is again approved. So this is my first SaaS which I have launched. So you can see if I go to the, like the footer, privacy policy and terms of service, again, it has different privacy policy and you can see a lot of things are similar and it is smaller because it uses very less Google information. And you have to give also the scope, like the email address I need, profile name, profile picture. You also give the scope directly here also. But here also you should mention what exactly are you taking out. So these two are my terms of service and Google privacy policy. So this was my first SaaS. So that's why the legal terms was less. But in GrabLink, I'm like integrating a lot of things. So that's why I've given that particular reference. So it completely depends on me. Now you've given the homepage, privacy policy, terms of links. Then again, the authorized domains, who are going to authorize this particular Google OAuth. So what happens is that right now, for example, if I give this, so this particular application can only authorize it. So if I give localhost 3000, then localhost 3000 can also refer it. So that doesn't matter much, but this is very important, like what are the authorized domains. So then again, for audience, you have to give, like, you have to go from testing. If you are testing it, you can do the publish app and you can see for external what exactly you have to do. So right now, if it is not verified, only 100 user cap is there. After 100, I cannot add more users. So for that, I need the verification. So you can see the audience, then the clients, like whatever clients you have created, like mobile, Android, desktop application, web client, and things like that. Then the data access you get. So you can see what are the scopes you can add. So for example, I only need that user email, user profile, and I don't need the open ID, so I don't need that, so I won't copy that. But if you need, you can copy and you can see what exactly do you need. So there are a lot of things which you need, and you can also manually add the scopes if you see it is not linked in. So that is you have to do after data access, after everything, like after giving, like getting all the scopes. Then you have to go to verification center. Now, after filling all that form, your status will show shown here. Like if someone has rejected your application, they will email you. They will email you with the reason. You can watch, you can fix it, and then you can reply to that email. So you can track the status. So this was all about Google OAuth screen, and I don't think so any more thing are required for you to know to get the hands on, and you can just copy my terms of policy, even privacy policy. That's it, and you will be good to go. So I wish you best and launch it successfully. And I will see you in the next video where I will talk about analytics. So till then, take care and bye.